It's extremely important to focus on preventing Active Directory, you know, attacks from occurring because they're happening much more frequently. Anybody out there on the planet can get access to free hacking tools to elevate their different skill sets. So the number of skilled attackers has grown exponentially since, you know, the, you know, early 2010s, right? Anybody can use the freeware tools. There's even paid tools people can buy to attack a different organization. The fact of the matter is ransomware operators are working with what's called internal access brokers, where sometimes they work with an employee that already works at an account or an organization and uses valid credentials, and they have a pathway to elevate up the permissions. They're going to use that. It's pretty easy for less technical people, and it's extremely easy for nation state organizations of that like. So by putting in different controls in place now, hopefully you can get to a point where you don't have to worry about using or implementing your AD recovery plan. But it's a journey. It takes a long time to be able to get there, and you have to know what your current state looks like so you can start putting those different controls in place. And the earlier you start that journey, the better off you're gonna be. Unfortunately, some of these different security models have been recommended going back to 2012, and very few organizations have started implementing them.
So you need to look at your Active Directory configurations. You need to look for those points of exposure, and you do it once and you make all the lights turn green, and that's great. But unless you're gonna pack it up and not use it again, it's going to drift. The configuration is going to change. And that is just a byproduct of actually living in and using a directory system.